Hi guys, I said I would do this video series, so I figure I may as well do it. I think I'm going to change up the name from what I originally had it. I figured I would start with the whole backup gun thing, just because it's probably the most boring of all the topics, and I'd like to get it out of the way. But at the same time, everyone's got an opinion on the backup gun thing. Everyone uses a backup gun for their own purposes, and you know, a lot of people will argue to the bitter end about what the best backup gun is. The fact of the matter is, the best backup gun is the gun that works when your primary gun isn't working. That's my philosophy, at least. Some people who play in tournaments will need a backup gun that is basically the same as their regular tournament gun, and they just kind of hedge their bets by having two or three of them. Some people will say, oh, when, you know, Tippmann 98's the only backup gun that you could want. And, well, yeah, I guess, I mean, it's reliable. But, you know, then you may as well say, like, a Spider's a good backup gun, or an Azodin's a good backup gun, or even an electro-pneumatic gun, like a cheap one, like an Ion, or an Axe or something like that would be a good backup gun. But then, you know, again, you're going up in the price range, and it depends what exactly you want a backup gun for. And that's really what it comes down to. What the hell do you want your backup gun for? So a lot of people also, their backup guns are their beginner gun. You know, they'll say, like, oh, paintball seems like kind of a cool sport. I think I might want to get into it. So they go out and they buy a cheap Walmart gun, or they go out and they buy just the cheapest gun they could find at their local paintball shop, if they even have a paintball shop. Some people don't. Maybe you go to A&S Gear, I don't know. And they just buy the cheapest one. And they say, I really like this game, but I feel like I'm limited by the semi-automatic single trigger and... you know, like, I just want that, you know, I hear that these guns can be so nice, and I don't see it with this, so I'm gonna go get a better gun. And then they get a better gun, that becomes their primary, and the old one, once their primary fucks up for the first time, they realize, should probably be brought along still, and it can be their backup. Myself, I didn't do that. The first gun I got was Brass Eagle T-Storm, which is a piece of shit. It lasted probably about 3 months before it just stopped working, for no apparent reason. Then I got a Tippmann A5, and I went with the Tippmann A5 for quite a while. It's good. It's got a lot of parts. I'll talk about the Tippmann A5 in a later video. It doesn't really fucking matter here. But eventually, I decided I wanted to get a backup gun. And my criteria for backup gun was that it has to be simple. Which means as few bells and whistles as possible. It has to be reliable, which I broke down to a time-tested operation that has as few O-rings as possible. And it has to be widely compatible. So those were my three, and by widely compatible I mean, like, I wanted an autococker barrel, I wanted, you know, 45 grips, I wanted a standard bottom line, which kind of automatically ruled out Tippmanns and Spiders. You know, I was looking at autocockers, and I love autocockers, but they're not the simplest guns to maintain or to operate or to set up. And the fact that you have to set them up at all kind of means they're not the simplest gun. So I ended up going with Azodin. I went with an Azodin Chaos. I can show you what an Azodin Chaos looks like. I've got it all ready here. So I just went with the simple blue one. It's a decent gun. It works. It's got one O-ring that's on the bolt here. Let me see if I can take this out. Sorry, you know what? The bolt doesn't even have the O-ring. The O-ring's on the hammer, which is in there, which I am not going to take out at the moment because this gun is pressurized and I can't find where to get it back in. So there's a lot of controversy as to should I get an Azodin, should I get a Tipman, should I get a Spider. The fact of the matter is they're all good. If you were to get a Tipman as a backup, you might want to try one of the, what are they called, the U.S. Army series or something. I mean, those are pretty simple. You could also get a Tipman 98, pretty simple, also very upgradable. You could get a Spider. Spiders are basically these, except these have autococker barrel, ion threaded feed neck, intimidator detents, 45 grip, standard bottom line ASA. So this happened to fulfill my requirements. It has never let me down. It is ridiculously reliable. I've had a Spider. I had a Spider TL Plus that I also loved. It was from 2003, I think it was. It was nice. It ran on CO2. It did not really like compressed air. It liked CO2, which, you know, if you're using a backup gun, sometimes you want the CO2. I have since sold it and the CO2. So I don't want a gun that runs on CO2. I tried running this gun on CO2, and I noticed a strange liquid dripping out of the barrel. And then I realized there was no puddle on the ground. And as I looked closer at the liquid dripping out of the barrel, I realized it was boiling liquid CO2 that was evaporating in the air as it was dripping to the ground. So that's something you want to consider. Frozen paintballs are something you don't necessarily want to be shooting at people, especially if I were to decide I wanted to play airball one day. And I go and, I'm running around, my primary gun breaks, and I say, fuck it, I drove all this way, I still want to play airball. I get this thing out, and I start rocking the, oh my god, keep working, just fucking pull the trigger. And then someone's at the bunker, and I walk up to them, and I'm monitoring the CO2, and I shoot them in the goggle, and it froze the paintball, and it goes right through the goggle. I don't want that to happen. So, I'm sure no one wants that to happen, so I don't use CO2 anymore. I don't use the Spider anymore. I'm interested to know what everyone's philosophy is with their backup guns. Some people just want the same gun that they have. You get two axes or two egos if you have the money. Or you get like an ego and a McDev. Or an ego and an intimidator. I don't know. I don't know what the hell I keep talking about egos for. So I'm interested to know what you think. I'll let you hear this thing shoot. It's really fucking loud, and as I'm sure you could tell, the trigger sounds like a farting baby, but here you go. Anyways, you're not sneaking up on anybody with this thing. Anyways, guys, I'll do something a lot more interesting for my next video. I've got a lot of guns, a lot of heavily modified guns, a lot of really old guns, a lot of really unique guns. And I just kind of want to share them, and I want to share how they operate. And the backup gun thing is more just a general backup gun thing. This is really nothing to show off. If anyone has any questions or wants to see anything in particular, let me know. Otherwise, I'm just going to slowly go through the ridiculous collection of guns that I have. Anyways, see y'all later.